Welcome back to Minecraft, everybody. It's been a good while since I've played Minecraft on the channel. If you've looked at my channel in the last few, years, it's pretty much been exclusively Halo content. And the funny thing is that most of my original viewership and subscribers come from Minecraft. So, you know what? This is for you guys who have at least stayed subscribed. I don't think anybody has watched my videos consistently, and I don't blame you. I don't really have an agenda with YouTube, so maybe this'll just be some fun, and maybe anyone who's still along for the ride will enjoy it. But yeah, I played Minecraft in ages, and with good reason, because I just burned out on it so badly, and you know what, that's okay. But yeah, we're back now, and I'm gonna try and enjoy it as much as I can, because I have been craving to play this game. It's a new mod pack, and I have no idea about the mods that are inside. I literally haven't a clue, which is good for me, because, literally, I could have named every single mod back in, 1.6.4, and now we're in 1.19.2, so this is ridiculous. This is, absurdly new for me. Let's make a crafting table. I believe we can make a crafting table on a stick in this. I saw someone do once. I haven't really watched any videos on it. I've seen some things, and there's some mods which I do remember, so there's that. So let's just make a wooden pick, do the old Minecraft 101 thing, mine some stone, make a better pick. But yeah, guys, we're also playing hardcore mode. I've never played hardcore mode before, so this is going to be brand new for me. Oh, cool, it's covered in water. I guess that means mobs can't spawn. So maybe we should start building, or at least digging here, because we'll know it's safe. But yeah, hardcore mode. I've never played hardcore before, so this is going to be a new experience for me. And also, I'm playing with shaders on, and I've never been able to run shaders before because my computers have never been amazing in the past. So. Now that I got a top-end rig, I can do something like this, and it's really nice. Also got on Sfax, POBD Craft. This is the texture pack I always used to rock back in the day, so it's feeling extremely nostalgic for me. This is absolutely great. But anyway, let's make our little sort of base over here, because why not? So yeah, guys, I haven't played Minecraft properly in ages. I've dabbled with friends and stuff, but not to the extent of trying to do a series or something like that. And what's really exciting now is that basically I feel like I've been out of the game long enough where I'm not the expert anymore, and that's good, because basically before it just felt like I was just going through the rhythm with it, and it wasn't anything new that was happening, and this is completely new to me now, so I'm really happy about that. Let's maybe go back one more block. And yeah, the last time I think I played properly was on the Strangecraft server, and I don't know if you guys were around for that, or or whatever, but basically I was on this SMP server with some really cool guys, and do you know what, I'm still on their Discord to this day, and they're really, really cool. I really recommend all of them. So if you want to check out Strangecraft, please do. They're great guys, and yeah, I did their logo. But yeah, basically, I had to quit Strangecraft because I didn't have enough time to make videos, and I was still in my last year of university at the time. Well, since then, I actually managed to finish uni, and I got a job immediately in exactly what I wanted to be doing. So I really, really lucked out with that. But I did say that maybe I'd return to Strangecraft one day. And with my job, that unfortunately wasn't possible because of how busy I was. So yeah, this is the first time since then I've actually played Minecraft properly. And the thing is as well, when you're in a design job, burning out on creativity is a serious risk. So I didn't really want to burn out, which is why I sort of kept creativity outside of work to a minimum, which is kind of sad when you think about it, but it's understandable. And I do love my job, so there is that. But yeah, we're finding lots of good stuff around here. Apples. I think I see apple trees earlier on? Because that would be really, really useful. There we go. Oh my god, apple trees. Okay, that's going to make the early stages a little more easy if I can just get some food off of a tree. I guess I could kill those sheep back there. Sheep back there, which I do intend to do. But yeah, this this texture pack as well, this Fax texture pack. Oh, can I get a sapling off of this actually? Yeah, this Fax texture pack is using the All the Mods patch, as well as my own sort of custom additions, which make the grass like how they used to look back in like 1.2.5 and all that. But yeah, I had to cobble together some of it, so there are going to be some missing textures. Like for Britannia, I think Britannia was just added to this mod pack, so I'm going to have to add that manually, which is completely fine. But yeah, I'm pretty happy with the way this has all turned out. This this texture pack, it looks absolutely beautiful. So yeah, let's try and get let's get a bed. So I'm going to need to kill these sheep, unfortunately. One more white wool. The only thing is now, oh, two more. Okay, fantastic. The this shadow from that giant airship thing is spawning mobs. So that's a bit of a bummer. Okay, I've got the wool. If I had a saddle, I'd come back for the horses, in fact. Saddle, you can't craft them. Okay, it was worth a try. Sleeping? Yeah, we can. A sleeping bag. It's literally just white wool. Oh my god, fantastic. So let's just do that. There we go, sleeping bag. We don't need to, like, set our spawn or anything because, I mean, it's hardcore mode. If we're dead, we're dead. So, let's not worry too much about that. Oh, sugarcane. Let's grab some of those in the early game. In fact, I should probably be getting some seeds, or at least wheat seeds, to try and breed some animals in the early game. That would be quite useful. What do wheat seeds look like? Industrial hemp. Aha, these are wheat seeds, aren't they? Yeah, they are. Okay. Sugarcane. So, yeah. It's another water ravine. Or is this the same one? Yes, it is, because it's got my little dig base around here. Let's get over here and let us make a... let's just start renovating this place a little. Because we don't want to die, do we? So let's make some doors. Let's also make a crafting table and a furnace. What the? Oh wait, that's not how you make a furnace. I have been playing this game for a while. Let's also make a double chest. I'll put the double chest. Oh, it's like an oak chest. That's pretty cool. Put the furnace down. Let's place these double doors. Hell yeah! Okay. I just realized I don't have any coal. I can probably make some charcoal. I'm fairly safe in this place, I would think, anyway, so let's not worry too much. Do I just right-click with it? No? Right-click on the... Yeah, there we go. Hell yeah, look at all these cheeves I'm getting. Hell yeah, okay, so we got our way down now. It's not that dangerous, luckily, and let us also create an oak boat. And we can just use this to sort of get around. Hell yeah. Okay, this is pretty cool. I really like being down here. There's copper. Copper is going to be useful, more useful than normal, because we're going to be playing, because this is modded Minecraft, but copper is going to be used for, like, all cables and things like that. So that's going to be pretty cool. There's a mod that I want to get into nice and early, and I believe it was Feed the Beast, what's it called? Industrial Contraptions? Cool. I won't type the whole thing in. But basically, this mod is a remake of an older mod called Industrial Craft. And Jesus Christ, it looks like... Yeah, I mean, it looks like just like it. So this is what we want to be doing first, to try and get some infrastructure going. It's even antimatter. I'm assuming that's meant to be universal utility matter. So that's pretty cool. I absolutely loved Industrial Craft when that was a thing. So... to see one of my favorite mods brought back to life as another mod is pretty cool. Let's dig this out, because that way we can get our boat into the sea, and then we have a swift exit if anything goes wrong on the surface. So yeah, that's pretty cool. Let's just clear a little bit more room. That's plenty of room, probably. Let's get the water back and just use the boat to get around a little bit, see what around here. I will make this bit bigger. Oh, what the hell is that? Also, is that a ship over there? We better be careful. Yeah, this is... Oh, and there's like a little hole in here. Is that something? That's like a cave. Soapstone. Okay, what the heck is this thing here? Should I build over to it? Use a bit of cobblestone. Okay. What's this? Environmental accumulator. That's something I don't know. There's like water here, so if I just break these, gives me stone slabs. Very nice. If I just break these, we can use these to just climb back up if need be. There's chests here. Compressed iron helmet. Diamond horse armor, that's pretty cool. Gold. A diamond, some bamboo. Kitty slippers. Creepers avoid the wear... That's pretty useful. Jesus. Okay, I'll take that. Incendiary minigun ammo. Okay, this is the part where it's like your inventory could just be filling up with stuff that you don't understand, so that's not, Fortunate chainmail chestplate. This item ignores 16% durability damage, plus luck 3. Is that good? I hope that's good. I got a bunch of achievements for it, so... Oh, there's a bunch of iron in here, that's useful. Curse of Vengeance. Using a tool to spawn vengeance spirits. Okay, maybe we'll leave that here for just for now. Stuff from Quark, Botania. Okay, do you know what? We'll take it. Let's equip our new stuff. Oh, is that making me faster? 15% total speed? Oh, jeez. Yeah, okay, that's pretty cool. And the slippers. Can't equip them. Are they like a bauble? Is there like a bauble slot for your feet, maybe? Can I just, like... Oh, it literally goes in the bottom one. Kitty slippers. Okay, that's pretty cool. We got some iron from that. So, yeah, that's pretty good. I'm pretty happy with that. Okay, so I absolutely scoured the mini-map. And luckily, I've just managed to find exactly what we needed. And I thought these were going to give me way more trouble, but it's actually okay. These are rubber trees from the My Trees mod. And what we really need to get from them now is just a sapling. We can do that just by removing all the leaves. Although I will need to cut some of these down anyway. Do we get enough saplings? What the hell is that? Nope. One sapling. Okay. That's not terrible, but I probably will need to fell a few of these trees. I'm hoping... Oh, there's another one up there. Okay, cool. Got another sapling. Let's grab our boat. While we are out, I just wanted to see this little crater here. I discovered some lava over there, and yeah, this is a applied energistics crater, I think. So it'll have a skystone chest in the middle, and it's got all this like basalt and stuff and like nethery stuff. That's not netherrack, but it's something similar. And, oh, is that? That's a block of coal. All right. Okay. Yeah, I'll take. Oh, wait a minute. Hang on. Are these all blocks of coal? Oh my god. Okay. Yeah, that's fair. I was going to say there's a surprising amount of coal ore here, but I may as well grab these blocks because you can't fortune them anyway. But, holy crap, that means we're going to be stocked on coal for quite a while. So if I just grab a few of these blocks of coal, we won't really need to worry about coal for the early game, which is really, really nice because running out of coal for your furnaces can just be a real pain sometimes. Okay, and in the middle there is usually a skystone chest, or in this case it's a loot chest. Some gold, a diamond, I'll take that, some nether quartz, iron, cobwebs, and some emeralds. Moonstone, I will not take those, but there. Yeah, there we go. Well, that's pretty good. We've got the... I'm more happy about the coal, to be honest. So I just killed some cows, and I do need some of these cobwebs that I just got. So if I just cut one of these up, I just get one piece of string, don't I? That's okay. I know cobwebs have got other uses than just turning into string, but in this case, we just want the string. So I'm just going to make a chest, and look at this now. So if we get the leather that we got from the cows, and two pieces of string... Oh, what was it? One more thing as well. Oh, no, it was four pieces of string. Okay, well, that does mean we're going to have to cut more of these up, which is fine, I suppose. We can always just find more or find a way to get more. That's the good thing about modded Minecraft, is you can usually get more of things. There we go, a backpack. So just make sure we're safe now while we are using our inventory. And if I just go into the bauble slot, I should be able to shift-click this in. There we go, it's on our back. And I think if I press B, yeah, it opens the backpack slot. And I think I have, yeah, waypoints I've moved to something else. So now we can put all of our stuff that we've collected on our travels into the backpack slot and have more room to actually carry stuff in our inventory. Okay, so from this mod that adds rubber trees, we do need to make a wooden bucket and a tree tap, as far as I know, and we need to grow a rubber tree. It is becoming nighttime, but that'll be okay. Now, I'm not sure if this will work with rubber wood blocks that we can place ourselves, because we have got 12 rubber wood from cutting down that tree. So let's try it with this real quick. And I think we need to maybe have another block above it and put that there. No, it doesn't seem to work. Okay, so I assume it needs to be a new tree. So if we just plant a tree here, maybe a few more around. And maybe we will actually try and just get a skeleton to get some bone meal. Got a few bones from that, so let's just make some bone meal. Wonder if any of the trees have grown naturally. No, it doesn't look like it. Hello, Mr. Creeper. Oh, he runs away because of my cat feet. Okay, there's one. There's another one, and that was all our bone meal. Okay, well that's fine, we can work with that for now. Where's the hoe? Okay, so as far as I can tell, we need to put a bowl down, and we need to put the tree tap there. There we go. And that still starts filling up with latex. So, I don't have much iron, but we probably should be spending our iron on this. So, I'm going to go get more tree taps. Okay, so what we need next is essentially just some basic materials, so copper, tin, and iron. I can get some from over here. There's plenty of copper to be had. In fact, copper is actually more useful in this mod pack than it is in vanilla Minecraft, which is quite funny. We'll probably just need about a stack of each. We don't really need that much more. Is there more here that I missed? That looks like tin to me. How am I going to get up there, though? I might just have to dig a way up. Yeah, that's tin. Fantastic. Now, iron is going to be the tough one to get because it's not always as common as it is in vanilla in these mod packs. Usually there's some mods that maybe overrule iron spawning or something, or get in the way of it, so it can be quite hard to get. I'll just have a look at these exposed caves first before we go down any deeper. But it's looking a little bit fruitless, to be honest. Oh, sugarcane, fantastic. Let's grab some of that. Let's keep an eye on our mini-map just to make sure we don't get crept up on by some monsters. This is why in hardcore mode, I like to keep my shield out. I feel like I'm just going to get creeped up on, although I guess creepers aren't really a huge issue with these kitty slippers. So, that's good. Ooh, what is here? Is this osmium or zinc? Okay, zinc. Osmium is from a mod called Mechanism, and that is like the ore that you will always need for everything. So we will need to collect a bit of osmium when we find some, but I think it spawns much deeper underground. We will also be needing some gravel for later on because of flint, so we'll grab some of that. Okay, so looks like these are all full, so if I just do this. There we go. Yeah, that sort of just gives me latex. It looks like each one can give you two. So I will grab as many of these as I can. It looks like they're already filling up and more have started spawning. So yeah, I'll have to make more in the long run, but I've grown more trees ready for that, so that will be all right. Okay, so I've sorted out the cave home a little bit, and I've managed to give all the chests signs so that we can take inventory of what we got. And we haven't got a whole lot. So one thing that we're going to need before we get started collecting materials is redstone, and that is for the machines that we're going to make. However, to get redstone, we're going to need to go digging. So we will have to do that now. So I'm just going to make an extra pickaxe for when we inevitably break the one that we're on now. And we're going to need to chop down some more trees and get some ladders. Trapdoors. Wooden logs. These. Boom. Oh, wow. Okay. That could have been bad for me. It looks like there's light down there as well, so we should probably be very careful going down. Oh my god, look at this. This is pretty cool. Let's put our light levels on and just make sure nothing can spawn. Is this diamond? Yes, it is. Fantastic. Okay, so we will need to make a diamond pickaxe, but I may just only grab the one since we already have two diamonds at home to do that. And so that way we can come back and fortune the other diamonds later. But this has opened up... Oh, shoot. This has opened up a whole sort of load of opportunities now. Oh, hell yeah, geode. Okay, these are quite cool. I think these are like... You can use these for making certain items with these crystals. So like if I get these amethysts now... There we go. I also get amethyst dust. And I think these grow back as well, so I can grab a few of these. And you can make things like a spyglass with them and a few other things. I'll grab a few of them. Oh wow, more diamonds. Okay, I did just literally just find another one just now for a diamond pickaxe. But I might not mine these just yet. I may need to go back for the other one that I saw earlier, because I can fortune them if I get a fortune enchantment. So ideally I don't want to just be mining all the diamonds that I can find. I prefer to just be just exposing them and maybe coming back later for them. But right now I just need redstone. It's a large vein as well. Oh, look. Zombie spawner, hell yeah, okay. That is two zombie spawners. What the hell are you? Oh, alright, bye-bye. No probs. Ah, Batman! If I remember rightly, these bat wings could be turned into leather. Yeah, cool. Is that a creeper? Cave creeper. Uranium. Okay, so to get started with the mod Industrial Contraptions, we're going to need a few things. Mostly copper, tin, redstone, and iron. We're also going to need some flint, some glass, and some of this latex stuff that we've been getting. Now, if you put the latex in the furnace, it creates rubber. And this is how we're going to be getting all our rubber from those rubber trees. And also, if you cook iron again, you get these industrial-grade metal bits. So we're going to take some of this industrial-grade metal, and we're going to run three across here, and we're just going to combine it with some glass, and that'll give us some fuses. Now, I don't really know, you only need like one fuse per machine, so 24 should last us quite a while. But we just want to keep collecting some of this metal and this rubber. And the next thing that we're going to want to do is get some of this copper. I'm going to put it across there, that'll give us copper wire. But copper wire... raw isn't going to be any good, so we need to insulate it, and that'll give us LV cable. So LV cable is just a cable, so if we start placing it on the ground, it can go up walls, it can go all around, and this lets you basically power your machines, and we're just going to be using it for that. It's also used in crafting though, so if we come back here now, and this is all from memory by the way, because I used to use this mod back in the day, and it's quite funny how I've, you know, come back to using it now. So we're going to want to craft some of these RE batteries. So first of all, we're going to need a furnace, and we're going to want to turn it into an iron furnace. That's with iron like this. I think all the furnace goes like that. There we go. We're also going to want three of these industrial grade metal bits, and we're going to want to put an LV battery on top. That'll give us a basic generator. Now the basic generator is going to allow us to turn coal into electricity. Now, what can we do with electricity? Well, first things first, we're probably going to want to store it. So if we just get some wood like this, get a cable up there, and get three of these LV batteries in place, we're going to make a battery box, or an LV battery box, and that'll let us store power. So, have we got any more rubber done? Yeah, some more rubber is done. So we're also going to want more of this cabling. So let's get some more of this. We may need to go outside and get some more latex soon. And there we go. We've also got more of this industrial grade metal, but we probably will need a bit more. So let's get a bit more iron to cook. Let's go with another 8. Get that down. So if we come in here now, I'm going to remove this torch here. It's probably enough light anyway. And we're going to get this back box, or the battery box, and we're just going to put it behind the wall. So the battery box has got a few sides to it. One of the sides is green. So if I pop it down over here facing me, the green side will always go facing the player. So in this case, all of these sides are all inputs, but the green side is an output. So what we can do is we can stick the generator on the top. Now the generator is directly adjacent to the block into an input slot. So if we put some coal in here, or we may even get some coal first. In fact, I'll just take 11 coal, put one coal in the generator. That'll start burning and it'll create power. So the power isn't going into the basic generator, it's going into the battery box. And so the battery box is going to be taking the electricity and we can output it. So we can put a few coal in here and basically that'll burn and give us electricity. I'll take it out for now just because we don't want to use too much coal too early. We might need to move this anyway. Also, I dug out this room to put some machines in. So with this industrial grade metal, we can put it in a ring and also put a fuse in the middle. That'll give us a machine block. And then with the machine block, we can use that to make machines. So what sort of machines would we want? Oh my god, that scared the hell out of me. Is that him over there, I'm assuming, all the way over there? Well, we don't have to deal with him right now. So yeah, with this machine block, we can combine this with a few things. So firstly, we're going to need an electronic circuit. So if I just get one of these, oh, redstone, and some redstone. So put the redstone along there, put this the wiring over there, and one of these in here. We get an electronic circuit. We're going to need some cobblestone, we're going to need that machine block, and then we're going to need the flint. That'll give us a macerator. So what can we do with a macerator, I hear you ask? Well, first of all, probably going to need some more of this rubber. So if we get a little bit more of this rubber, we can create some of these, more of these LV cables. So now we want to connect an LV cable there and put one down here. And we're going to want a macerator to come here. So what does a macerator do? Well, you can put any ore you want in it. So raw iron, for instance. And it has got a chance, a 1 in 3 chance, of giving you an extra piece of iron or any metal, depending on what it macerates. So it just gave us one there. There we go. It literally just gave us an extra one there. So we only macerated 2 pieces of iron, but so far we've got 3 iron dust. 3 iron dust are smelt into an iron ingot each. So this is actually making our ore processing 1/3 times more efficient. So yeah, the iron dust that we get from the macerator literally just smelts into iron bars. So yeah, we're making more iron than we would if we just cooked it. So we should just macerate all of our, all of our items before we do anything with them. But there is absolutely more that you can do with these, and I will show you once I make some more of this industrial grade metal. Okay, so first of all, we need to make a few more of these LV cables. I'm gonna make this into another circuit. We're gonna need a little bit of iron. Make another furnace. Turn that into an iron furnace. And then we put this in with the electronic circuit and 2 redstone, and that'll make a powered furnace. Powered furnace does exactly what it says. It just is a furnace that works off of power, so electricity. So that'll charge up like that. And now we can use this to cook things that we get from the macerator. So I could put this straight in, and it'll cook it a little bit faster as well. Okay, so we're going to make one more machine here. So we'll get the machine block. It is also, I think we also need again another load of copper wire. So make some more of those because we will be needing another circuit. Ah, we don't have the, where's the industrial grade metal? There it is. Okay, so believe it is like this. We need another... oh, do you know what? This is the one machine I can't remember. Yeah, okay, so we will actually be needing more industrial-grade metal. Actually, never mind. I just literally realized we just crafted a machine block, so I don't know why I said all that. But basically, we can make this with tree taps, and we get a centrifuge. And the centrifuge is pretty cool. So first of all, let's just go and grab some more latex. So here's another 10 latex, and we'll chuck down the centrifuge, and we'll chuck it in the centrifuge. And usually with latex, if we put it in a furnace, we'll just get one latex, and that'll turn into one piece of rubber. However, if we centrifuge it, each piece of latex was worth 3 rubber. So essentially, we'd be tripling our rubber output from what we get from our rubber trees. So this is going to be really good, because it means now only 2 latex, and we get to make a bunch of copper cables. So that's really, really good by me. Okay, so there's one more machine I'd like to make. So I'm going to chuck down one more LV cable. We don't actually need this machine right now. However, it would be nice just to have for the long run. So we're just going to smelt our copper, get some more LV cable. Run back. We're just going to craft this into more LV cable. We got our rubber because we can get loads of that now from the rubber trees. And then we need to craft another basic circuit. And then we need to craft another machine frame. Boom. And then we're going to craft it like this with some stone. And that's going to give us a compressor. So the compressor is pretty useful. Basically it compresses things. So in the case of, like, say, carbon. So we can make this carbon armor. So in this case we'll need carbon plates. They're made with a compressor using carbon fiber mesh, which is from coal, essentially, which is really good because we're right next to a coal meteorite. So if we can get, like, we can get fortune on a pickaxe, that'll be extremely useful for us to get all this carbon. But it has other uses as well, like you can make plant matter and stuff, and you can use it to, well, just compress a lot of other things. So that's pretty cool. But anyway, we've got all these machines now, and we will try and automate them soon. But for now, we'll just have to leave them the way they are. Now, to automate them, we could just use hoppers, like in vanilla Minecraft, but then you're using your ceiling space and all that. There's one thing I'd like to try, logistical transporters. Now, the problem is with logistical transporters is that they require steel. Steel is from mechanism. Steel you get from carbonating iron, energized smelter. I believe you need to get from steel dust, which then you get from... Yeah, the metallurgic infuser is the way that people do it. So you're enriching iron, enriching it again, and that gives you the steel dust. And you also need a control circuit, which you also get from metallurgic infusion. Now, the good news is that the metallurgic infuser isn't that expensive. You just need some osmium and some of this. And the good news is as well, even though it'll run off of mechanism power, it will actually use zaps. So we can use our industrial craft... why am I putting coal in there? It will use our sort of industrial contraptions power system, so we can make some logistical transporters using that. I would also like to make an enrichment chamber, which will help us more efficiently use our carbon and redstone for infusion. But yeah, that's pretty cool, right? We made some pretty cool progress. I think next time we will have to work on some better defense and maybe starting... to build a real house above ground and not living in a ravine. This is pretty cool. So in the meantime, yeah, I'm going to do some off-camera mining. I'm going to get some resources. I'm going to macerate it. I'm going to smelt them. And look at all that extra, all this extra copper we're getting. And we'll probably get some more infrastructure in place. I'd like to maybe sort out the rubber trees as well. But yeah, not a bad start for a first episode. Still got a full line of machines and a generator. Do you know what we could even do is set up a bamboo farm that then sends the bamboo into the generator to be turning into free power, because bamboo is smeltable. So yeah, that's pretty cool. Anyway, yeah, hope you enjoyed the episode. We'll get more progress next time, and yeah, see you soon. Goodbye.